group of Metro East students have set up a solution to an everyday problem. News 11's Patrick Clark introduces us to the robotics team making accessible opportunities for all.
Tracking the progress of this robotic team, their aim is focused and their solution's real. An accessible solution for the students from St. John Newman Catholic School in Maryville, Illinois.
It worked out really well for our first time. As our first little prototypes, we used an American Girl doll wheelchair, and we tried it with different popsicle sticks. We tried a sushi mat.
It's the Passable Path.
So it's a mat that is made out of painted yardsticks, and it helps people in wheelchairs get over uneven terrains like grass, gravel, snow, and sand.
The 4th through 8th graders are getting some practice on their project before the first robotics competition in Champaign, Illinois, January 25th. There, they'll showcase their solution to an everyday problem.
So they had to identify a problem in their community, and so this summer we went on a community scavenger hunt. And so we went around the community and identified a potential problem, and the kids found that in their park they had a great paved path to walk on, but to get to the parks and the picnic tables, get to the benches and the picnic tables, you had to go through grass. And so given that one of the teammates is in a wheelchair, they knew that would be difficult for her.
Using yardsticks and ribbon tacked together, the team, Scrambled Gears, has come up with a build that provides traction in terrain that's unfriendly to a wheelchair.
I think it would be good if we had them at parks, because it can get muddy, and sometimes when a wheelchair wants to go somewhere, they can't go there.
I would really like it to go into parks and nursing homes, too, since my aunt is in a wheelchair.
Using the real world to call on for inspiration, these St. John Newman Catholic School students will take their robots, Black Widow and Superman, to the competition January 25th. And they'll measure their success of the passable path at 36 inches, thanks to some ingenuity and yardsticks. In Maryville, Illinois, Patrick Clark, News 11.